Blessed be God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
And blessed be his kingdom, now and forever. Amen.
Almighty God, unto whom all hearts are open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hid, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of thy Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love thee and worthily magnify thy holy name through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Hear what our Lord Jesus Christ saith. Thou shalt love the Lord thy God with all thy heart, with all thy soul, and with all thy mind. This is the first and great commandment, and the second is like unto it. Thou shalt love your neighbors as yourself. On these two commandments hang all the law and the prophets.
Thank you.
Let us pray. O God, whose blessed Son was manifested that he might destroy the works of the devil and make us the children of God and heirs of eternal life, grant us, we beseech thee, that having this hope, we may purify ourselves even as he is pure, that when he shall appear again with power and great glory, we may be made like unto him is in his eternal and glorious kingdom, wherewith thee, O Father, and thee, O Holy Ghost, he liveth and reigneth, ever one God, world without end.
A reading from the prophet Job. Oh, that my words were now written. Oh, that they were printed in a book. That they were graven with an iron pen and lead in the rock forever. For I know that my Redeemer liveth, and that he shall stand at the latter day upon the earth. And though after my skin worms destroy this body, yet in my flesh shall I see God, whom I shall see for myself, and mine eyes shall behold, and not another. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
reading from the book of 2 Thessalonians. Now we beseech you, brethren, by the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ, and by our gathering together unto him, that ye be not soon shaken in mind, or be troubled, neither by spirit, nor by word, nor by letter as from us, as the day of Christ is at hand. Let no man deceive you by any means, for that day shall not come, except there come a falling away first, and the man of sin be revealed, the son of perdition, who opposeth and exalteth himself above all that is called God, or that is worshipped, so that he as God sitteth in the temple of God, showing himself that he is God. Remember ye not that when I was with you, I told these things to you? But we are bound to give thanks always to God for your brethren, beloved of the Lord, because God hath from the beginning chosen you to salvation through sanctification of the Spirit and belief of the truth, whereunto he called you by our gospel to the obtaining of the glory of our Lord Jesus Christ. Therefore, brethren, stand fast and hold the traditions which ye have been taught, whether by word or our epistle. Now our Lord Jesus Christ himself, and God, even our Father, which hath loved us and hath given us everlasting consolation, a good hope through grace, comfort your hearts and establish you in every good work and word. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
Certain of the Sadducees, which deny that there is any resurrection. And they asked him, saying, Master, Moses wrote unto us, if any man's brother die having a wife, and he die without children, that his brother should take his wife and raise up seed unto his brother. There were therefore seven brethren. And the first took a wife and died without children. And the second took her to wife, and he died childless. And the third took her, and in like manner the seven also, and they left no children, and died. Last of all, the woman died also. Therefore, in the resurrection, whose wife of them is she? For seven had her to wife. And Jesus answering said unto them, The children of this world marry and are given in marriage, but they which shall be accounted worthy to obtain that world and the resurrection from the dead neither marry nor are given in marriage. Neither can they die any more, for they are equal unto the angels and are the children of God, being the children of the resurrection. Now that the dead are raised, even Moses showed at the bush, when he calleth the Lord the God of Abraham and the God of Isaac and the God of Jacob. For he is not a God of the dead, but of the living. For all live unto him. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise be to you, Lord Christ.
Celebrating the presence of Christ with you, and I realized after being in Ohio just how much I miss and love you, and I am just as honored to be your priest today as I was a year and a half ago. So let's talk a little bit about family dynamics. So the Pharisees and the Sadducees, as we know, like to trip Jesus up a few times. They like to try to ask him questions and get him caught up. Because Jesus is in Galilee and people are following after him and he's getting pretty popular, and the religious leaders don't like that because it's all about power. By the way, Bill, I hope that somewhere there's a scripture that says, Luke, I am your father, because I want to hear you say that. So you got these two groups, the Pharisees and the Sadducees. The Sadducees were sad, you see, because they did not believe in a resurrection. They believed in only the books of Moses. That's all that counted. Anything outside of Moses didn't count. It didn't matter. So they were sad, you see. The Pharisees were fair because they believed that there was more than just the Mosaic books, but they believed like books of Daniel, prophetic books that talked a little bit about life after death, a little bit more that there's more to life than just dying. So they were kind of fair. And Jesus is telling them about resurrection.
Well, what if you got seven brothers and seven wives and all that?
Jesus, I can imagine Jesus is thinking to himself, really? Like, this is the game we're playing about seven wives and seven brothers? And he said, let's just get back to the basics. Let's talk about the God that you saw, that Moses saw in the burning bush. let's talk about that God. Do you guys believe in that God? And the Pharisees said, yes, we believe in that God. Good, because that is the God of the living, not the God of the dead. And not too long after that, Christ goes to the cross, is crucified, dies, is buried, and then on the third day, he's resurrected, and now we begin to understand what resurrection really is. Because through his resurrection, the last stronghold there was on this planet, the last thing that conquered humanity was broken because of the resurrection. And because of resurrection, God reminds us through that, that he is the God of the living, not the God of the dead. What does that mean for us? What's my sermon about today? Well, we'll figure it out as we go along. But right now, what I'm feeling is that the sermon for today is to remind us at St. John's that we are a people of resurrection and life, not people of death and surrender. That is exactly what Jesus was telling them. God is a God of life. Don't be sad when you think life is over, because life is not ending, it's actually beginning. You think I time those things on purpose, but I don't. What does it mean to be people of resurrection? It doesn't mean that we don't feel sorrow. It doesn't mean that we don't feel sadness. It doesn't mean that we don't feel those moments of grief when we have the loss of a loved one or a friend. Because those things are real. Yet there's something underneath that that says, despite my own sorrow, despite how I feel right now, I have a joy that bubbles up because this is not the end, that I know I will see that person again someday. Now, what we do know from what Jesus said is that there's not going to be marriage in heaven. I was waiting to see if anybody was going to say amen. There might be Facebook. There is no marriage in heaven. But we know through Scripture that we will know each other and be known. And here's the difference. We will be in joy and fill of rejoicing because we will literally be in the presence of God where time and space completely change and don't matter, and we live in a life of freedom where we're not bound by this world, we're not bound by brokenness, we're not bound by this physical body, we're not bound by the junk that goes around us, but we live in an experience as God intended us to live in perfect relationship with him, and we can rejoice in that. What does that mean? I remember once I preached on heaven, and I'm really happy to have my dean from Bexley Seabury when I was a student there amongst us. I'm not going to point him out, but I'm glad he's here. And he is a mentor and a dear friend to me. But I remember, and he knows where I was serving. I was serving at a church. I preached on heaven, and it was a wealthy community, and they had great golf courses and great restaurants and all the fancy things. And the email went like this: Father, I appreciated your sermon on heaven. However, I am very wealthy. I love golf. I eat at the finest restaurants in Columbus. And I'm not quite so sure that I want to go to heaven. Reply, you're well on your way. What does it mean? It means to live into this resurrection life means we look past, beyond, that all the blessings of this life that we have are but a glimpse of what God has in store for us. When I look out that back door, I see absolute beauty. Here, there you are. I look out the back door, I see the beauty of God's creation. I see hills, I see water, I see what God has created. And do you know that despite how beautiful it is nothing but a touch of what God has in store for us. When I think about the relationships that I have with so many of you, when I think about relationships within my family, and I think what a beautiful creation of love that God has given us through marriage and through relationships, it pales in relation to what God has in store for us in heaven. It is small and it is minor because there is so much more. What am I saying? To be people of resurrection means we start living like people of resurrection now. Stop walking around like the world is falling on our heads, because we have a hope that goes beyond this world. The motto for the state is hope. But guess what? The motto for the church is hope in Jesus Christ, because on him and on his resurrection, we have hope that life continues beyond this earth and continues in a way that gives us joy that is unspeakable and full of God's glory. So I know that as good as life could be, it's going to get better. So I can walk around with a little bit of a smile on my face, right? When I ache a little bit, it's okay, because God's got something better. When someone says, I'm hurting, I say, I can relate, and let's pray that God will be with you, because I know there's something better. When things are going perfect, thank God things are going perfect. Just wait a minute, because you know they'll change. But for right now, they're going perfect, and I rejoice, and I know that even in that, God has something better. And treat each other like God has something better for them too. Be people of resurrection. We are not people of death. Right? That's what Jesus said. Sophie says, she makes a game of how many times they say Jesus in a sermon. Be people of resurrection. Life is not always easy. Life can be challenging, but I know this, that we serve a God who is our creator, and he is our redeemer, and he has been our sustainer in this life, to know that there's a future that goes beyond what we see and hear and feel and touch in this world. And so for that, I don't care how many wives there are or how many sons and children are getting married, it doesn't matter, because our Lord is resurrected. That's where the Gospels tell us. Luke tells us, Paul tells us, we read in the Gospels of this resurrection where they witnessed it, where they saw it and talked and experienced Jesus in a new way that we can experience as the church today. So, as I say every week, rejoice in the Lord always. And again, in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
I believe in one God.
holy sacrifice of this Mass is offered to the greater glory of God. And in thanksgiving for the glorious resurrection and ascension of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. In thanksgiving for the gift of the Holy Spirit at Pentecost. And in thanksgiving for all the blessings of this life, including those for whom we offer our thanksgivings now, silently or aloud. For those celebrating birthdays this week, especially Gerald, Marvin, and all those for whom we offer our thanksgivings now, silently or aloud. For all those celebrating anniversaries this week, especially John and Carol, and for all those we offer thanksgiving now, silently or aloud. We remember those for whom our prayers have been asked, especially those on the parish prayer list, for all those affected by the coronavirus pandemic, and for all those for whom we pray now, silently or aloud. Among them, we remember Joseph, Teresa, Chuck, Patrick, Richard, June, George, Raymond, Pam, Ed, and Melinda, and for all those for whom we pray and love. We pray for the repose of the souls of the recently departed, and for those whose year's mind falls this week, especially Charles, priest and rector, Richard, Roy, priest, and Eugene. And for all those we remember now, silently or aloud. For the departed members of the Guild of All Souls, for the departed sisters and associates of the Holy Nativity, for all those who have died in the war in Ukraine, and for those who have been victims of violence in our own country. May their souls and the souls of all the faithful departed, through the mercies of God, rest in peace. Amen. Father, we pray for thy holy Catholic Church.
And for all that you want.
Grant that every member of the Church may truly and humbly serve thee.
That thou may be glorified by all people.
We pray for all bishops, priests, and deacons.
That they may be faithful sisters.
We pray for all who govern and hold authority in the nations of the world.
That there may be justice and peace on the earth.
Give us grace to do thy will in all that we undertake.
That our works may find favor in thy sight.
Have compassion on those who suffer from any grief or trouble.
That they may be delivered from their distress.
Give to the departed eternal rest. Praise thee for thy saints who have entered into joy.
May we also come to share in thy heavenly kingdom.
Let us pray for our own needs and those of others. O Lord our God, accept the fervent prayers of thy people. In the multitude of thy mercies, live with compassion upon us and all who turn to thee for help. For thou art gracious, O lover of souls, and to thee we give glory, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, now and forever.
Amen.
Ye who do truly and earnestly repent you of your sins, and are in love and charity with your neighbors, and intend to lead a new life, follow the commandments of God, and walk from henceforth in his holy ways. Draw near with faith, and take this holy sacrament to your comfort, and make your humble confession to Almighty God, devoutly kneeling. Almighty God, Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, maker of all things, judge of all men, we acknowledge and deliver our name from the sins and iniquities, which we from time to time most grievously have committed, by thought, word, and deed, against thy divine majesty, invoking Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, who of his great mercy hath promised forgiveness of sins to all those who with hearty repentance and true faith turn unto him, have mercy, pardon you, and deliver you from all your sins, confirm and strengthen you in all goodness, and bring you to everlasting life through Jesus Christ our Lord. The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And with your spirit.
Peace and love. Good morning. Please be seated. Welcome. If you are here for the first time, you are welcome at this place and we are glad you are with us. All baptized believers are welcome to come and receive communion. This is God's table, not ours, so you are welcome to receive the body and blood of our Lord. A few announcements. One is this afternoon at 4 o'clock. Big doings going on at St. John's, the Concert of Remembrance at 4 o'clock. So right after Mass, we need some help. And we have to set up some candles and get everything ready for the service, for the concert. So, Bill, if you could stand up. Lindsay, if you could stand up. If you could find one of these two people after Mass and offer them your assistance. We have to set up Mass number of candles. Thank you. Around the church. So if you could just get with one of them, they will help you and direct you. We've got to move some candles and set up some other candles. And lots of candles. And so we need your help with that. Also, Monday, morning prayer at 8:30 with evening prayer at 5:30. Tuesday, Mass at 6 o'clock, we'll resume. And then Thursday, morning prayer at 8:30, evening prayer at 5:30. And that'll bring us to the conclusion of the week. And we come back again on Sunday at 8 and at 10. As I said before, it is good to be back. It was a nice vacation, believe it or not. But it was just as nice to get home and be back with you all. I feel, really the first day, I feel like I'm more like myself. I'm thankful for that. So, I want to give a special thank you to all that kind of helped out while I was away. Father Mead, of course Cheryl, our senior warden, so many that helped fill in. Also, we had Diocesan Convention last night and yesterday morning. And I want to thank Ann Boyer and, where is she? Thank you, Ann and Chris Moe, for serving as a parish delegates. It was a nice, short diocesan meeting. I think it was 3 hours. It was amazing how they did that. But we celebrated Bishop Nisland's 10th year as our bishop, and we look forward to many more. Along with that, I was elected to standing committee, which is scary, but it's going to be great, and I'm excited to serve the diocese and be part of that. Anything I'm missing? Any other announcements? Anybody? Going once, going twice? Okay. Walk in love as Christ loved us and gave himself for us as an offering and sacrifice to God.
Thank you.
Pray, my brothers and sisters, that this, my sacrifice and yours, may be acceptable to God the Father Almighty. The Lord be with you.
And with thy spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks unto our Lord God. At all times and in all places, give thanks unto thee, O Lord, Holy Father, Almighty, everlasting God, who by water and the Holy Spirit hast made us a new people in Jesus Christ our Lord, to show forth thy glory in all the world. Therefore, with angels and archangels, and with all the company of heaven, we laud and magnify thy glorious name, evermore praising thee and saying, to suffer death upon the cross for our redemption, who made thereby his one oblation of himself once offered, a full, perfect, and sufficient sacrifice, oblation, and satisfaction for the sins of the whole world, and did institute and in his holy gospel command us to continue a perpetual memory of that his precious death and sacrifice until his coming again. For the night in which he was betrayed, he took bread. And when he had given thanks, he broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take, eat. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." Likewise, after supper, he took the cup. And when he had given thanks, he gave to them, saying, "Drink ye all of this, for this is my blood of the New Testament, which is shed for you and for many for the remission of sins. Do this as oft as you shall drink it, in remembrance of me." institution of thy dearly beloved Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ, we, thy humble servants, do celebrate and make here before thy divine majesty with these thy holy gifts, which we now offer unto thee, the memorial thy Son hath commanded us to make, having in remembrance his blessed passion and precious death, his mighty resurrection and glorious ascension, rendering unto thee most hearty thanks for the innumerable benefits procured unto us by the same. And we most humbly beseech thee, O merciful Father, to hear us, and of thy almighty goodness vouchsafe to bless and sanctify with thy word and Holy Spirit these thy gifts and creatures of bread and wine, that we, receiving them according to thy Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ's holy institution, in remembrance of his death and passion, may be partakers of his most blessed body and blood. And we earnestly desire thy fatherly goodness, mercifully to accept this, our sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving, most humbly beseeching thee to grant that by the merits and death of thy Son, Jesus Christ, and through faith in his blood, we and all thy whole church may obtain remission of our sins and all other benefits of his passion. And here we offer and present unto thee, O Lord, ourselves, our souls, and bodies, to be a reasonable, holy, and living sacrifice unto thee, humbly beseeching thee that we and all others who shall be partakers of this holy communion may worthily receive the most precious body and blood of thy Son, Jesus Christ, be filled with thy grace and heavenly benediction, and made one body with him, that he may dwell in us and we in him. And although we are unworthy through our manifold sins to offer unto thee any sacrifice, yet we beseech thee to accept this our bounden duty and service, not waive our merits, but pardoning our offenses through Jesus Christ our Lord. By whom and with whom and in whom, in the unity of the Holy Ghost, all honor and glory be unto thee, O Father Almighty, world without end. And now, as our Savior Christ hath taught us, we are bold to say, our Father, our Passover is sacrificed for us.
Therefore, let us keep the
feast.
our sinful bodies may be made clean by his body, and our souls washed in the most precious blood, and that we may evermore dwell in him and he in us. The gifts of God for the people of God.
Thank you.
Almighty and ever-living God, we most heartily thank thee for that thou dost vouchsafe to feed us, who have duly received these holy mysteries with the spiritual food of the most precious body and blood of thy Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ, and dost assure us thereby of thy favor and goodness towards us, and that we are very members incorporate in the mystical body of thy Son, which is a blessed company of all faithful people, and are also heirs through hope of thy everlasting kingdom, by the merits of his most precious death and passion. And we humbly beseech thee, O Heavenly Father, so to assist us with thy grace, that we may continue in that holy fellowship and do all such good works as thou hast prepared for us. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord, to whom with thee and the Holy Ghost be all honor and glory, world without end. Amen. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit descend upon you and remain with you always.
Amen.
Go in peace to love and serve the Lord.